Hello and welcome back to Revender in Sports, and a quick update again on my 400K Brevet that was on Saturday, April the 20th. And so Sunday, Monday, today's Tuesday, so 3 days hence. And I'm feeling a lot better. I did a video on Monday, so yeah, just yesterday. So I guess you could look at that video and look at today's video and you could start to see my recovery. So on Monday, I just felt really bad. I was achy, which I still am, leg-wise, but I was still sleep-deprived. So I don't think I looked all that chipper. But, you know, there was Jesse just swimming in the background. And so if you haven't seen that video, please take a look at that. But what I wanted to talk about today is that I'm trying to synchronize my schedule with Jess so that Thursday, her and I can do a rev show. So today being Tuesday, so 2 days from now, so it gives you about 2 days. We'd like to do a rev show. We haven't done one in a bit, but it will be mainly focused on the fact that she has sagged for me on the last two events, my 300 kilometer event and the 400 kilometer event. So April 6th and April 20th. And sadly, she had to sag. And I'm also forever grateful that she sagged. But what I mean by sadly is I wish she was actually riding with me instead. But what I'd like to do is in this video or any of the other videos, but please, I don't know, I forget what GCN does when they do a hashtag so that people can find questions. They used to do like a hashtag ask GCN or GCN tech. So I don't know, hashtag ask Rev. So hashtag, spell out the whole word ask, and R-E-V for Red-Eyed Vario, which is who I am in my ultra alter ego. So ask Rev, and we'll try to include your questions in our sit-down so she can give her perspective from being SAG. I'll give my perspective from riding the event. And we also have a little bit of footage that I took while riding, and we have some footage that Jess took while riding. I'm sorry, while sagging. And so I'm compiling that right now. It was over, it's like an hour and 16, hour 26 minutes of footage. So I'm paring it down. I think we're down to like 50, 53, 54 minutes. But, you know, I don't want to cut out too much because there are a lot of times when the camera's rolling and things come up, and I want to leave those in. So pretty much each one of the SAG stops are almost left to its entirety. I've cut out some things, but I also want to leave that in so folks can see that, hey, I'm in and out of a control, which would be the same thing if I was doing a double century, supported double century, or if I was doing, you know, my 500 milers when I was doing those. So I'm not that fast of a rider. My power numbers are not anything to brag about, but what I am very good at, and depending on the situation, you know, most of that 400K, I was running neck and neck with one and two, you know, first person. Towards the latter part of the event was Aaron and myself back and forth, right? Trading places between each one of the controls until we finally decided to work together, which I offered, hey, look, you know, we've been trying to stay away from each other all day. Let's just finish off these last 60 miles together. And that worked out because he was having some troubles, digestive issues. And I put him on my I put him on my product, on my Rev Energy, and totally fixed his stomach. And he came back charging towards the finish, which was awesome to see him come back. But I just want to show in my videos that, hey, look, in and out of a control, out of a sag stop, out of a checkpoint, you know, beware of the chair, never sit down. You sit down, you're going to be there for a bit. So, but I want to open it up for questions, comments. We'll pick a few of them. So Ask Rev is the hashtag. If there are some topics that you'd like to see, you know, a whole video dedicated towards it, then also make that comment down below, because, you know, some of these questions I might be able to answer in a few minutes as part of a longer Rev show, but some topics may deserve their own video for that kind of stuff. So I do want to talk about equipment. I want to talk about nutrition. I want to talk about clothing, the course, and a few other things. So if you folks have those questions, drop them down below. And I don't know if I'll do anything longer this year. There is a 600K coming up. It's now less than 2 weeks away. As much as I suffered on this 400, I don't know that I want to do that 600. It has 26,000 feet of climbing, so basically 8,000 meters. But it goes into our deserts, and based on the time that you get to those desert climb, especially the one out of Borrego Springs up Montezuma Grade, I mean, we're talking the end of, was it May? I'm sorry, end of April or beginning of May. I forget what date it is. It can be 90 plus degrees with a tailwind in May, Borrego Springs. And, you know, summer temps in Borrego Springs are over 100. So just to give you an idea, that is our deserts. And it's so close to where the ocean is, or to where an alpine climb would be here in San Diego, which is why I absolutely love living here, training here. Racing here is hard, but living here, training here is great. But when you race here, God, it's just so, so much climbing. Anyway, I want to make this channel about education and inspiration. I've gotten a few comments from a gentleman named Peter Hench. Apologize if I don't remember exactly your name, but I know it's Peter. And one of the comments he made, I forget which video, he said, "You're an inspiration." I've heard that over the years, and I'm humbled when people say that. But the methodology while I'm writing is like, I even think about that. I'm like, okay, I'm suffering, but if I can get someone off the couch, if I can get one rider to extend from their comfort level of doing, you know, 50 milers to do that first metric century of 62 miles, or that first 30 mile ride for that person sitting on the couch, or if I can get someone to get their first century in, and they're like, you know, you inspired me to do that first century. You inspired me to do my first 200K purvey. If that's you, please make a comment down below, because for so many years, my suffering has been kind of about that, trying to get folks to see what is possible, to see that even if you're suffering, it is possible if you just keep pedaling. Okay, anyway, enough philosophy for now. Please like and subscribe, and we will see you up the road.